Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
He is exalted, the King is exalted on high. I will praise Him. He is exalted, forever exalted, and I will.
Dear God, thank you for tonight. Thank you, Father, for giving us the opportunity to come together in this virtual space to listen to your word, to meditate, Father, and to be refreshed, to be reinvigorated with your words. Lord, we thank you for the church year that has passed. We thank you, Father, for getting us through. Thank you, Father, for being our strength when we were so weak. Thank you, Father, for being our peace when all around us were but chaos. Thank you, Father, for being our wisdom when we were so confused on all the things that are happening around us, all the things that are running inside our brains. Lord, thank you for being our provider when we were in dire need. We know, Father, that our thanksgiving, our words are not enough, of Father, to thank you for all the mercies and grace that you have showered upon us. But please accept our offering. Please accept our thanksgiving, O Father. Lord, we pray that as we prepare for another church year, may you bless us, O Father, and may you use us mightily, O Father, to become the hands and feet of Jesus. And may you use us, O Father, as channels of your blessings, of your mercies, of your grace, O Lord. I pray, O Father, that may you bless all those who are listening in our daily devotion. May you reach out to them, O Father, and minister to them at their points of need. I pray, Father, that May you so reach us and transform us so that after tonight's devotion, we are even more encouraged, Father, to continue with our faith journey. Continue, Father, with a renewed hope that everything that we are experiencing right now, the challenges, the trials that we have, will also come to pass and will emerge victoriously, just as Jesus did. Cleanse our hearts and thoughts, Father, from anything that may hinder us from receiving your message tonight. We ask all of this in the precious and matchless name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Oh,
reading from Zephaniah chapter 3, verses 14 to 20. A song of joy. Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart, O daughter Jerusalem. The Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies. The King of Israel, the Lord, is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day it shall be said to Jerusalem, Do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing, as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you, so that you will not bear reproach for it. I will deal with all your oppressors at that time, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. At that time, I will bring you home, at the time when I gather you, for I will make you renowned and praised among all the peoples of the earth, when I restore your fortunes before your eyes, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Sing a new song to the Lord, he to whom wonders belong.
Good evening, brothers and sisters. I invite you to tonight's meditation on a song of joy. What songs are you currently listening to? I remember being asked by a friend one time, and as a chorister, I didn't know how to answer because of the many songs I am studying and practicing at the moment. The conversation on that what songs question eventually ended in a conversation where we both agreed that no matter the genre or the artist or the groove and rhythm, whatever I am listening to may have a great impact on my day and even my whole life. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for this wonderful night. Thank you, Father, for gathering us in this virtual space. Thank you, Father, for the technology. And thank you, Father, for all the people working behind the scenes so that this ministry, our daily devotion, will happen every single night. This we ask in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Our reading for today has the title, A Song of Joy. Now, let me ask you, brothers and sisters, what is your song of joy today? Or what is your song of joy this season? I don't wish to create a discourse or to start an argument. I would just like to invite you instead to journey with me on our passage for tonight. The first time I read the passage, I was immediately captured by verse 17. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exalt over you with loud singing. And why would this not capture me? Imagine God in our midst. It's not our usual imagery of God here. Here, God is given a picture of a warrior. When you are fighting so many battles like me, imagine a companion, a warrior that is, who is also the God of this universe. Wouldn't that bring a smile to your face? Maybe even more than a smile or a grin that is from ear to ear. Depending on the weight of the battle you are fighting, this should be a sweet song indeed. To me, it's more than sweet. I could have diabetes. But, you know, as we look further in our reading for tonight, we can see more of what this song of joy is about. The second part that really spoke to me is verse 19, where God says, I will deal with all your oppressors at that time, and I will save the lame and gather the outcast, and I will change their shame into praise and renown in all the earth. Isn't that comforting? I submit to you that, you know, the general theme of this passage tonight mirrors that of the Apostle Paul's letter to the Philippians in verse 4, where he says to rejoice always. Let us walk through the other part of the passages. We could see that the daughter of Zion, Israel, was not yet in their desired situation or favorable environment. In fact, this is a part where the religious state of Judah declined markedly following the death of Hezekiah. We see from verse 16 words like, on that day, and on verse 17, I will, even on verse 20 are words like, at that time, right? These good things have yet to happen. It was not yet happening. It is still to come. And this may be the case for you and me. This may be the case for many nations trying to combat this current pandemic. While here in Barbados, no matter what is your position on vaccines here, we can boast of more than 34% of our population being fully vaccinated. Some countries are yet to receive their first dose of the vaccine. While some of us may be trying to balance adjusting to the new work setup and balancing work and life, hundreds and even thousands are yet to get their jobs back. On a personal level, your breakthrough may not be there yet. Your dreams, goals may not be in sight yet. Your full recovery or your complete healing may not be certain as yet. But you know what? Some are no more because they have passed on. Verse 14 encourages us to sing. In fact, not just sing, but sing aloud. It is then followed by the words rejoice and exalt. Now, this is interesting. We have heard over and over again that joy is totally different from happiness. Happiness depends on happenings, but joy is deeper. Whatever happens in our surroundings, we can have joy. Of course, I'm not asking you to be happy for a death of a brother or a sister, for someone contracting the disease, for some countries who are recording hundreds and even thousands of COVID cases. No, not at all. But see, we can only have that joy when we anchor it on the Lord. The word exalt, as per the Oxford Dictionary, is to feel or to show triumphant elation or jubilation. So from rejoice to exalt. Imagine this song of joy that tells us there's triumph already, there's jubilee, there's victory. All of this, even if it is yet to happen. This month seems to be a roller coaster ride for me. From work, to school, to proposals, to writings, to plans, to sorting out 11 of my countrymen who have been stranded on the island since August 8. What a timely reminder from God that I do not have to face this alone. Whenever I check on my social media account, there's not a month that I don't see a friend change a profile photo with a candle. Also, when I look at the news, especially in my dear country in the Southeast Asia, I couldn't help but be overwhelmed. But from our reading, even these things shall also come to pass. In verse 20, we can even read that God will bring all of us home. God will restore our fortunes before our eyes. How about you, my dear brothers and sisters? What situations are you currently in? Do you need deliverance? Are you currently fighting a battle and are in need of a warrior companion? What is your fight song, or what are your fight songs? Have you lost joy and the zest to move forward? I invite you to make Zephaniah chapter 3 verses 14 to 20 your song of joy. Together, let us all make its melodies and harmonies permeate your situation, and let us make its rhythm and dynamics push all of us into a joyful and triumphant jubilation. Soon and very soon, the things that we are hoping for will come into being. The things that we are currently experiencing, the hardships, the trials, the challenges, will also come to pass. And while we are waiting for it to happen, let God's song of joy become our joyful song, our song of thanksgiving, our fight song. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts tonight be acceptable to our God. Amen.
You are Go now and rejoice in the Lord always. Do not be afraid or worried about anything, but in everything trust God and pray. Bear fruits worthy of repentance, sharing what you have and being gentle with all. And may God rejoice over you with gladness. May Christ Jesus renew you in his love, and may the Holy Spirit give you peace beyond understanding to guard your hearts and minds in Christ. We go in peace to love and serve the Lord in the name of Christ. Amen.
Thank you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to His word, and may it dwell in all of us richly.